I dig this.
Fine, how are you?
I think we'll be alright. Merry Christmas Eve.
Merry Christmas Eve.
Thanks for coming to church this morning and being here with us. Christmas Eve, we'll have different services today and it's gonna be really wonderful. And so you pick your times and come and join us whenever you like. But I'm glad you're here this morning. Thank you for being here. We wanna do birthdays because it goes all the way to the end of the year. And I know Barbara Pitsley would want us to make sure and sing happy birthday to her because she was born on New Year's Day, right? So we got to make sure and sing to her today. Anybody else have birthdays from here to the end of the year? Nobody? Oh, I see a hand. Who's back there? Who's that?
Ashlyn,
you have a birthday? Oh, happy birthday. Happy birthday. Anybody else? Ooh, Karen.
Cy's birthday is the 27th, and he'll be watching.
Cy is the 27th? How many is Cy this year?
10.
10. This is a good year for him. That's the year you get a motorcycle. That's a good grandpa and grandma.
Park it in your garage.
Yeah. You can do that. You can do that. Ooh, happy birthday. All right, let's sing happy birthday to these folks. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, God bless you. Happy birthday to you. Any anniversaries to celebrate the end of the year? All right, if you're with your honey, tell them thanks for sticking it out with me. I love it. Merry Christmas Eve today. It's quite a deal. His story, our journey. At Christmas, we remember the birth of our Savior, Jesus Christ. We're going to stand and sing Joy to the World this morning. I got the words up here on the screen for us. Joy to the world on Christmas Eve. Joy to the world on Christmas Eve. All right. Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him room. And heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven nature sing. Joy to the earth, the Savior reigns. Let men their songs employ, while fields and floods, rocks, hills, and plains repeat the sounding joy, repeat the sounding joy. Repeat, repeat the sounding joy. No more let sins and sorrows grow, nor thorns infest the ground. He comes to make his blessings flow, far as the curse is found, far as the curse is found. Far as the curse is found. He rules the world with truth and grace, and makes the nations prove the glories of his righteousness, and wonders of his love, and wonders of his love. And wonders, wonders of his love. Christmas is all about love, so practice. Give your neighbor a big hug and kiss. Tell him Jesus loves you. Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas. Yeah, you got to be practicing lots of hugs today and tomorrow. Everybody needs that love. We're talking about that love that Jesus gives. Hey, we're going to sing that song the angels remind us about. Hark the herald angels sing. Hark the herald angels sing. Glory to the newborn King. Peace on earth and mercy mild, God and sinners reconciled. Joyful all ye nations rise, join the triumph of the skies. With the angelic host proclaim, Christ is born in Bethlehem. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Christ by highest heaven adored, Christ the everlasting Lord. Late in time behold him come, offspring of the virgin's womb. Veiled in flesh the Godhead sees, hail the incarnate deity. Pleases men with men to dwell, Jesus our Emmanuel. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Hail the heaven-born Prince of Peace,
Hail the Son of Righteousness, light and life to all he brings, risen with healing in his wings. Mild he lays his glory by, born that man no more may die, born to raise us sons of earth, born to give them second birth. Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King.
I'm going to ask you to take your hymnals, if you would. Turn to number 29. And Connor and Caleb are going to come and read the Advent scripture for us this morning. And I'm very pleased for them. We're reading from John chapter 1, verses 1 through 18. A little bit of a hidden part of the Christmas story this year. A little bit of a hidden, those Advent candles. Should I raise the curtain for Caleb? Hold on, Caleb, then you don't hit your head on that. Just in time. Yeah. Thank you, man. Thank you for being here. Go right ahead.
We're reading from John 1. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was the God in the beginning. Through him all things were made. Without him nothing was made that had been made. In him was life, and that life was the light of man. The light shines in the darkness, but the darkness has not understood it. There came a man who was sent from God. His name was John. He came as a witness to testify concerning that the light, so that through him all men might believe. He himself was not the light. He came only as a witness to the light. The true light was that gives light to every man was coming into the world.
He was in the world, and through the world was made through him. The world did not recognize him. He came to that which was his own, but his own did not receive him. Yet to all who received him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God. Children born not natural descent, nor of human decision or a husband's will, but born of God. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and the only, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. John testifies concerning him. He cries out, saying this, that he was he of whom I said, he whom comes after me has surpassed me, because he was before me. From the fullness of his grace, we have all received one blessing after another. For the law was given through Moses. Grace and truth come through Jesus Christ. No one has ever seen God, but God, the one and the only, who is the Father's side, has made him known.
I light all the candles this morning. Christ candle, the candle of hope, the candle of peace, the candle of joy, and the candle of love. We're going to pray. And I'm going to ask you to stand with me because we're going to pray the Lord's Prayer. Almighty Father in heaven, living Lord Jesus and Holy Spirit, Christmas Eve, this day, we come in remembrance of you and your great plan of salvation for us. But through all that is, the scriptures these young men have read for us today remind us that you have created all from the very beginning, and you brought the light into the world. And Jesus, you passed that light on to us today, and we will not forget. And that light represented your great love for us that was brought to us. And so, Father, this day on Christmas Eve, may we not forget how much you love us. Thank you, Father. Thank you for sending Jesus to bring salvation to us. And by our believing and committing our lives to follow Jesus Christ, we shall have the fulfillment of salvation one day in heaven above. So thank you this day, Father. Would you pray with me? Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Take your hymnals, please. Number 29, O Little Town of Bethlehem. How still we see thee lie above thy deep and dreamless sleep. The silent stars go by, yet in the dark street shine the everlasting light. The hopes and fears of all the years are meant in thee. Verse 2. For Christ is born. And praises sing to God the King. And peace to men on. Verse 3. How silently the wondrous gift is given. So God imparts to human hearts the blessings of his heaven. No ear may hear his coming, but in this world of sin, where meek souls will receive him still, the dear Christ enters. And the last verse. O holy child of Bethlehem, descend to us, we pray. Cast out our sin and enter in. Be born in us today. We hear the Christmas angels, the great glad tidings tell. Oh, come to us, abide with us, our Lord Emmanuel. Thank you. You may be seated. If you have your Bibles and you want to open to John chapter 1 for just a few moments this morning, we're going to share some of this scripture together to be reminded of the great gift of Jesus coming to this earth. John chapter 1 verses 1 through 18 are the boys read for us, and I appreciate them very much doing that this morning. This Christmas we've been thinking about the icons of Christmas, and we talked about how they bring us closer to God. Sometimes they bring distractions our way, and we have to be so careful around Christmas. The four we've talked about is the Christmas tree, the star, the angels, and the manger. I don't know about you, but I've been going out in the evenings and looking up to the heavens a lot this Christmas season and how beautiful it is. So this morning we want to talk about a manger. Last week you witnessed a wonderful reenactment of the whole event that actually took place in Bethlehem 2,000 years ago. Did you hear me? Last Sunday, you witnessed an actual event of what took place 2,000 years ago in Jerusalem. Now, I don't know that it was that way, because the animals weren't talking, were they? But this is a symbol that no matter where you see it, what time of year, everywhere in the world, we know what it's about, don't we? I was thinking some of that processes and the different peoples and the different ways that it's represented, from pictures and art to ceramics. How many of you have a ceramic set of the Nativity? We have one of those. It was painted by a family member. How about those nativities out in the yards with lights, and we display them for everyone to see? And I have often been envious. Up in Lusk, they have one by the railroad car on the north end of Main Street. It's all LED nativity. And I thought it would be nice to borrow that just during Christmas time and put it in the churchyard. And I thought maybe I shouldn't steal the nativity from another town to put it by the church. But it's really splendid. I love it. We see them outside of figurines and lit up. We see them inside of kids' models. We have one of those where the kids play with, and sometimes they get to hiding them around the house, and we've got to find them in different places. We see very simple ones made out of very elementary materials. And yet they all mean the same thing, don't they? No matter where they come from, no matter what they're made of, no matter how they are. I got reminded this year as well. Barbara made one for us, and since we're talking about her for a moment, Barbara made one for us several years ago. She knitted one. And some of you, I think, got one like this. Did you? Anybody see this one? It got hidden in the kids' room for a long time, and I couldn't find all the little characters. I found them. So here they are. They're all stuffed in this little manger thing, and it closes up like that. How nice is that? She knit them for families, and they would give them to the kids to play with. And it's pretty wonderful. I don't know if baby Jesus is in there. Maybe he's lost. I'm going to have to go looking for him. Barbara Pinsley did that. I think about this kind. This was given to the church a number of years ago. It's usually up there on the altar, so you don't get to see it very well. But in the cross is a nativity scene. And this was made for us. The name's on the bottom. Do you know who made this? Doug Harvey made these. He went home to heaven several years ago already, didn't he? Doug had made that, and Rhonda gave it to the church. I was thinking about that. We received this one as a nice Christmas gift this year, as a Christmas ball to hang on the tree. And I thought, how do they even do that? And then you can look it up, you know, on YouTube and see how all that stuff's made. And I think of the wonders of it. Someplace in the world, there may be people making these, and they may not know what they even are. And yet here they are holding them, waiting for someone to tell them the story about how Jesus came and was born in a manger for us. So everywhere in the world around Christmas, I think about this nativity idea and this idea of the manger, how it blesses our hearts, and how whenever we see that icon of Christmas, we know exactly what that represents for us. Some people push it away as they don't want to look at that and be reminded of that love and that part of the story, as Christmas is just a nice time to be with family and friends and give things. But this is the reason that Christmas came about. This very story is what it's all about, is the love that God had for us. So when we read from John, it's appropriate because, you know, by chapter 3, we get to verse 16, don't we? For God so loved the world that he sent his son. Whoever believes in Jesus as the Savior of the world, as the Son of God, shall not perish but have everlasting life. That's the hope and promise of Christmas, and it comes to us through this love. When love came down, it's reminded to us by this little thing, the scene of this nativity, however you see it, however you look at it. So things that help us feel love around Christmas time. I know you do. When we see the lights around town at Christmas, it reminds us somehow of something warm and loving. When we spend time with each other, and we even tell stories about this guy, right? The other night, Nan and I sat down and we were reminded to watch, how many have seen in 30 years, The Miracle on 34th Street? The last videoing of that was done almost 30 years ago. And don't you love that court scene when they finally say, "In God we trust"? And it comes all around to that moment where we think about how God has blessed us. We're reminded of loving hands and gifts and good yummies. And sometimes when we partake those, we think about each of you and say, thank you for those good gifts, right? That our hands have made. How about gifts that you just pass to one another in different ways? It shows love. And above all, how about the music of Christmas season? Another part of giving in Christmas season is giving to organizations. And I was reminded of this last week. I had got an email from this organization, Samaritan's Purse. They don't just do the Christmas shoeboxes. Although by tomorrow, you know, millions of those will have been delivered all over the world. Right? I asked Dave Anderson how many boxes they had received over at North Hills, because they were our area who collected them all and got them down to Denver, and they go through them. He said it was just right around 1,000 shoeboxes that they were processing right there at church. And then they got them down to Denver and they shipped them out. The other thing organizations like this do, we forget sometimes, that in the email they said, giving this time of year for $35, they provide a meal for a person for a whole month in Ukraine right now. And I thought, what was Christmas like in Ukraine? And how different it might be in parts of the world, right? No matter how you tell the story, it comes down to this moment. This moment. The fulfillment of more prophecies in Scripture than any others. The story of a message that was given, and the sign was a baby in a manger. And you saw the pictures last week of the kids. No matter what we do this time of year, it comes to this moment, this gift of love. And John chapter 1 reminds us of that. As Jesus came into the world, he brought God's love and it became alive for us today. So the word we have for that, that you know is so well, the name Emmanuel, God is with us. So today on Christmas Eve, I hope you remember to say Emmanuel and whisper it to each other throughout the day and throughout tomorrow. Just walk by somebody and whisper the word Emmanuel. And you know what will come to their mind? A picture like this. A picture like this. A picture of a nativity, a manger, and a baby who changed the world. God sent his son. Why? Because he loved us. God loves us. What did you receive this year, and what will you receive that is more precious than that? God loves us. My prayer is, let the light move me closer to Jesus this Christmas as I receive the miracles of love from heaven above. Today we're going to share in communion. And it's such a precious time of year. This communion reminds us, again, always the one most important thing is Jesus said, do this in remembrance of me. And on Christmas Eve, it's always special because we come up to the rail and we receive communion on two times a year, on Maundy Thursday service, when we celebrate the resurrection of Jesus, our Savior, and on Christmas, when we celebrate the birth of Jesus, our Savior. So this morning, I'm going to invite you to come up and have communion with us right here. We do that pretty simple. You just make your way to the center aisle, walk up here, stand for a moment, I'll bring communion to you. And then when you're done, if you could go out around the outside aisles, that would be great, and then have your seat. We're also going to have a candlelight service this morning. And it was talked about at the church board meeting. I says, well, why would we light candles on Sunday morning? It's, you know, it's bright. And I was reminded gently by one astute scholar of our church, the moderator and leader of our group. He said this so gently. He said, well, you know, the light of Christ is good any time of day, not just in the dark. And And I said, that is true, Steve Fagler. So we will light our candles. And God provided overcast skies so they'll almost shine bright like they will this evening. But the scripture the boys read in John chapter 1 tells us the light came into the world in the person of Christ. And when we follow and believe in Jesus, we shine that light for everyone. So Anna and Beth have a duet they're going to play for us. I'm so anxious for you to hear it. They've been practicing. And while they do, I'll ask the deacons to come and prepare a communion for us. And then I'll invite you to come up for communion. Okay? All right. Thank you. Next time we'll hear the angels sing, we'll be in heaven, won't we? Pretty wonderful. The Lord Jesus, on his last night here on earth, before he died on the cross, he sat with his disciples at the Last Supper. And it says that after supper, he took the bread. It says he broke the bread and he gave thanks. Father, this is my body which is broken for these people, all the way to us and beyond. Jesus gave his life as a sacrifice that our bodies might be whole. And he said, when you eat this bread, do this in remembrance of me. And then in the same way, he took the cup. He said, this cup represents my blood that is poured out for you, for the forgiveness of sin. So whenever we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. So Christmas time, we're reminded that Jesus came with those 33 and a half years with us, guiding us on a path to get to heaven. So as we come today and share communion, we do this in remembrance of Jesus. Will you bow in prayer with me? Father, we are so blessed to have this reminder today on Christmas Eve, remembering Jesus as our Savior and how he has changed not only our lives today and brought hope to us today,
but the fulfillment of that one day we look forward to. I'm reminded of having Rachel Schreiner's funeral on Friday and how she trusted Christ her whole life. And now, Father, you have her in your hands. Those are promises we have from Scripture. So, Lord, as we come today on Christmas Eve, bless us, we pray. And let the light of Christ be in us this day. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. I'm going to ask you one row at a time, if you draw, please, and share communion. Thank you. Jesus has said about the light and the message that is going to be to us. Brings our hope and salvation to us. Thank you, Jesus, for your saving and your love. Thank you. 38, where the words are silent night. We're going to light our candles in a moment. I'm going to do it. It's a little darker, isn't it? The light of the world is Jesus. And when he came, he brought his light to change everything. The light that we passed this morning represents your faith in him. Receive communion, you know him as your Savior, but now the light goes with you as you lead, and you shine that furthermore in this world to see, so they know where you're going and they can go with us. Thank you for bearing the light of the world to us, Jesus. Thank you. I'm going to ask you to stand. Remember the rules of the candle. Person that the unlit candle has the tipping. And don't put your candle too far in front of you. And all those good things. The light of the world is Jesus. We're going to sing while we pass the light. Jesus. All right, lift your lights up so everybody can see. Now look around a little bit. This is our community. These people carry the light of Jesus with us. Not just in Christmas and into the new year, but we carry the light of Jesus all the way to heaven, right? God blessed us with that. Christmas reminds us. On count of three, we're going to blow our lights off. We're going to go have a Merry Christmas, right? But remember the light. Remember the light. Thank you, Father, for the light of the world. In your name. Amen? Amen. On the count of three, we'll go now. One, two, three. God bless you and thank you for coming to church this morning. God bless you and thank you for coming to church this morning.